Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar. In this video, we are going to set up ingress controller on Kubernetes environment. It is four-part video series. In part one, we are going to set up ingress controller. In second part, we are going to set up domain or virtual host-based routing. In third part of video, we are going to set up TLS or HTTPS on ingress controller. And in the final part of the video, we are integrating the load balancer with the ingress controller. Ingress controller support application or virtual host routing on layer 7 in OSI model. Let's understand the ingress controller with the examples. For example, this is my current Kubernetes cluster environment and external traffic is going to load balancer and then on Kubernetes worker machines. Now, if you want to host multiple application on your Kubernetes cluster environment like abc.com, 123.com, xyz.com, all domains are pointing out on same load balancer. In that case, ingress controller will accept all the traffic from the load balancer and route the traffic of the multiple application to the appropriate containers across the worker machines. Take one more example. Suppose that abc.com has multiple backend services like East, West, Asia, and Europe. These services can access by the end user on the application URL like abc.com/east-west-asia-and-europe. In that case, ingress controller will accept all the requests that is coming on abc.com and forward to appropriate container based on application host path. East traffic will route on worker 1, Asia traffic will route on worker 2, and so on. Take one more example, how ingress controller will help to run multiple application on same node port. You can't run multiple application on port 80. What ingress will do here? Ingress will accept all the traffic that is coming on port 80 and route the traffic on appropriate container based on some of the algorithm. We will discuss about it in detail in next video. There is no standard ingress controller that is built with the Kubernetes. User must install one of the ingress controller on Kubernetes environment. There are many ingress controller available. You can install any of them according your requirement. In this video, we are going to install most popular ingress controller from Nginx. You can check out the source code on GitHub. Be careful when you select the ingress controller from Nginx because there is similar product available with the same name from different Kubernetes community. So this ingress Nginx is supported or maintained by the Kubernetes communities, and this Kubernetes ingress supported and maintained by Nginx, and we are going to install Nginx supported ingress controller in our environment. We should able to access Kubernetes worker machine on port 80 and 443 after implementing of ingress controller. Let's try to access port 80 before implementation. This is my Kubernetes cluster environment, one master and two worker machine. This is the IP address of worker machine 1. We are not able to access the worker machine on port 80. Let's try to second node also. This is the second node IP address. No, it is not working. Let's start implementing of ingress controller. Go ahead and clone this directory. Go inside the Kubernetes ingress folder. Now go to in folder deployments. Step number one, let's create a namespace and service account for Ingress Controller. Let me explain the content of this file before applying. This file is going to create a service account and namespace. Let's go ahead and apply this file. In second step, we are going to create a TLS certificate and a key for the default Nginx server. You can create or use your own TLS certificate. In this demonstration, we are using a default. Go ahead and apply this file. Step number three, you can customize your Nginx controller. You can refer this documentation to customize your Nginx behavior. For this demonstration, I am going with the default Nginx configuration. Go ahead and apply this file. In step number four, you can limit the resources on the Kubernetes environment for Nginx controller. Please make sure that your Ingress controller start with the option enable custom resources in step number three. Go ahead and apply this file on your Kubernetes environment. Custom resource definition has been created. Step number four, configure the RBAC. If role-based access control is enabled in your cluster, create a cluster role and assign to Nginx service account. This is the rbac.yml file and we are creating a cluster role on multiple resources like service, endpoints, secrets, config maps, ports, etc. And we are providing a cluster level permission like get, list, watch, update, create, etc. And we are binding the cluster to the Nginx service account. Let's go ahead and apply this file. Require RBAC object has been created. Now we require to deploy the Ingress controller in our Kubernetes environment. There are two options to deploy Nginx controller. One is deployment and second is daemon set. I would prefer to use daemon set because daemon set is making sure Ingress controller is going to run on every node in a cluster. If you go deployment approach, there is no guarantee Ingress controller is going to run on every node. It might be possible that one worker machine is having multiple copy of Ingress controller and other don't. Let's look at daemon set deployment file. It is daemon set kind. We are using the Nginx Ingress image. Port 80 and 443 is open on host and container level. We are providing these arguments in this file. Go ahead and deploy Ingress controller by using daemon set. Daemon set or Ingress controller deployment has been done. Let's verify the Ingress controller deployment. This is the namespace we are using for the Ingress controller. Containers are creating for each worker machine. Okay, now it is running. Two containers are running in this deployment. We can verify that Ingress controller is running on each node, worker 01 and worker 02. Now let's try to access port 80 and 443 on the browser. If you remember, connection was getting refused on port 80 by the worker machine. before implementing Nginx Ingress Controller. Since now we have implemented Ingress Controller, our both the worker machine should listen and accept the traffic on port 80 and 443. Let's try once again to access or browse port 80 on both worker machine. That's excellent. We received the 404 error. It means that Ingress Controller started to accept traffic on port 80 and respond back. Since we haven't configured the backend service correctly to respond the request in Ingress Controller, hence Ingress Controller is throwing 404 error for all unknown domain or host URL. In next video, we are going to configure the domain or path-based routing to respond on port 80. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.